Everybody, my name is Jonathan. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I will bring here an epic battle that most people wondered. It's about what makes me to decide to use Affinity Designer in my daily job instead of Adobe Illustrator. So if you guys are interested about this topic, make sure to hit the subscribe button already and the like and stay tuned on the final. And now guys, what I'm gonna show you, it is the difference between the layers management, alright? Basically, I'm going to start by showing you an example. I will import this SVG, alright, to work in both of them. I will drag and drop here on Affinity Designer. As you guys can see, it's already imported. And now I'm going to import the same file to Adobe Illustrator, alright? I will open here and drag and drop. Click OK. And look you guys, the biggest difference that I can tell you, it's about the layers management, okay? So if I want to just select the eagle on here, you need to click in this button in order to move them. So if you select just the layer and try to move, you know, for example, I want to select the eagle, it's going to move all of them, you know. And another hand, when you are using Affinity Designer, let me show you, this is Affinity Designer, and you guys can see a better and optimized way to see the layers. And if you click here, you can move the eagle. If you click here, you can move the flag. And if you want to just select the beak, you can move easily. I'm going to click here in preference just to show you my settings that I'm using. All right, I'm using the settings, hardware selection enabled, preferences. And we are going to have the performance. And you will see here these options, all right? I'm using the same GPU option, okay? I'm going to create a rectangle. And if I change the position, as you guys can see, you cannot see in real time. And also, if I change the color on here, you will not be able to see in real time. Look, using Affinity Designer, I'm going to create here a rectangle, okay? And let me change the color already. As you guys can see, the color changed in real time. And if I change here the position, try to apply a drop shadow effect behind of this eagle. I'm going to apply on here using Affinity Designer. I will click at the outer shadow. And you guys will see this screen. Okay. And also about the blending and the colors, I can also change by these sliders. Now using the Illustrator, I'm going to select this layer, okay, the eagle layer, and I will apply on here below. And I'm going to use here drop shadow. And in order to see, you need to click here preview, all right? And you guys can change this just by increasing on here. I will try to apply the blur, you know, seems working nice, this one. Also, you guys can change here. You need to click, you know, if you try to just over the mouse in these options, you cannot see in real time. I think Affinity Designer is pretty well optimized software. So there is one thing that I really enjoy about Adobe Illustrator is a feature that many Affinity users are requesting to Affinity. For example, if I paste here this, let me show you this cube. This is an image, all right? This is a pixel. I can click on here and make the image trace, all right? That converts this to vector, you know? This is a really amazing feature that I think people really enjoy on Affinity Designer. And this feature is really a game changing. Unfortunately, Affinity Designer, you cannot do such features like this. You need to design this manually. Truly believe that what makes people choose Affinity Designer is because the interface is very intuitive. As you guys can see on here, the color you can change to the well, you know. On Adobe Photoshop, this one you need to have the colors a plugin just to have this option on here, you know. And let's check it out about the Adobe Illustrator in another hand to compare them. And we have this small slider, all right? And if we see here the options, we cannot see the well. I'm going to show you the difference between them using the clipping mask. Alright, using Adobe Illustrator, I will create a rectangle just to clip the head of this eagle. Okay, and I will try to clip just by selecting, let's say that you are a beginner and you are going to try to clip on here, make, and it's telling us that you cannot clip by different groups. Alright, let's drag this object inside of the same group. And now let's try to select them both. And of course, you guys can press these hotkeys in order to do that. Alright, so as you guys can see, the clip has been done successfully. And let's do the same functionality using Affinity Designer. On here, you guys just need to draw a rectangle and just drag inside of this layer. And you guys can control here easily, as you guys can see, very optimized way. And in another hand, using Adobe Illustrator, I will try just to move this, but it's selecting this group, you know. Say that we have a nice feature on Adobe Illustrator, because I'm not here just to tell you that Affinity Designer is better than Adobe Illustrator just because I use Affinity Designer. No. Okay, I'm going to design these shapes on here, okay, just to show you about this feature that I enjoy. It is about the shape builder. I'm going to select these three shapes that I've created. And if I select here the shape builder, you guys can just merge them, you can subtract, you know, as you guys can see. This is a very nice feature that I really like it, you know. And also, Adobe Illustrator has a lot of features, you know, like 3D, like warp, you know. This is a really good in case you work a lot with kind of graphic design, I'd say. So basically, in my personal experience, I use Affinity Designer because I enjoy more. The basic tools that I need is enough to build my designs, you know. Of course, with more features we have, more happy we stay, of course. But I have to say, for the basic stuffs, if you're a beginner and you just need to design, you know, your illustration, I'd say Affinity Designer is very good and very optimized. And also because of the iPad, I can design my stuff. If you guys want to learn, make sure that you can join in my Patreon in order to learn more about Affinity Designer and how to do illustrations like I do. Now I'm going to use the feature that I like to use all the time. All right, it's about the layer effects. I'm going to use right now the Adobe Illustrator and the layer effects over this rectangle that I've created, right? I'm going to apply here on the blur section, Gaussian blur. You need to click on here in the preview in order to see, you know, and if you change here, you cannot see in real time. It's not so well applied, the Gaussian blur. And let's try to do this on Affinity Designer. I'm going to click on here. Apply Gaussian blur, and look, it seems to work pretty well, better than Adobe Illustrator for me. Okay, so basically, the optimization that I can notice between the both softwares, Affinity Designer is so far better. How you guys can export your project to your game, to your client, I'm gonna use right now the Adobe Illustrator, and as you guys can see, I will select the layer that I want to export, like this one, and I have this panel, the asset export. So if I click on here, in this button, it's going to create a single asset based in my selection, all right? Like I'm doing, I can create multiple assets. I need to
always click in this button. This is very annoying to me, really.
I can set here the scale that I want to export this by the width, by the height and resolution. And these are the formats that I want to export, you know, SVG, PDF, right? And you guys can just click on here, you know, and export your assets. And now let's take a look at the Affinity Designer export persona by clicking on here. And you guys will see this interface, you know. And I have here the layers. I'm going to create here at this panel, create slice, you know, the same settings that I've used on Adobe Illustrator. And I want to create another slice on here by clicking this big Okay, so I have these two slides, all right, and I can set here the scale like I did on Adobe Illustrator, and you guys can set also another types of file and format. Okay, we have a lot of functionalities like JPEG, GIF, TIFF, SVG, EPS, PDF, PSD. I like to use PSD to open on Photoshop, and we have a lot of options. Also, you guys can name on here a kind of pattern for your slice. You know, I can name here, for example, you know, and I can copy this. Let me change this name, Eagle. And the name will be displayed on here, as you guys can notice. Okay, in the, if I copy this and paste on here, look, I can just type here big and object big and object eagle. So let's say that you want to export this. I will export this right now. I'll click on here. Okay, and if I select this option, this continuous option, and open that folder, all right, like you guys can see, the file is already exported as PNG on here. I want to export this as JPEG, and as this option is selected, the continuous, the JPEG will be exported automatically like this one. Let me change this as JPEG, and look, it's going to be exported automatically. And if you guys want to make some changes, you know, these are going to change on there as well. Look, I have changed it, and it's changed at the export folder. This is really awesome, really, because you can change in a real time to your client while you are doing your project. Okay, I really enjoy this feature because I work with games and I need to always do a lot of changes, you know, make some assets and different colors of objects. On here, I can switch to the raster and the vector when I want. Select your paintbrush and start to make some kind of sketches, you know. And this is pretty awesome, you know, the way that you can use the same software to create your sketches. So guys, I'd say that Adobe Illustrator is still requested by the most company in the world. But with many people getting into the Affinity Designer and the Affinity Photo, many people are leaving the Adobe subscription just to get Affinity software because it's a one-time purchase instead of the Adobe subscription. This is a really good, you know, to have competitors, because for a long time I have seen Adobe Illustrator getting, I'd say, worse about the updates. Of course, with a lot of features that you guys can see, probably you are not going to use all of them. I'd say that I don't use a lot of these features, you know. Of course, features like auto tracing would help us, you know, to grab an image from the internet and vector automatically, of course. So guys, I'm not here to tell you that the Adobe Illustrator is better or Affinity is better. No, it depends about what you need, what you guys like most. I'm showing you here my perspective that I got when I, you know, I entered in this vector design world. And for beginners, I think the Affinity is more user-friendly, I'd say. If you guys want to learn, make sure that you can join in my Patreon in order to learn more about Affinity Designer and how to do illustrations like I do. Okay, guys, thank you so much. I hope to see you in the next video. All right, see you guys. Bye-bye.